So hi everyone, welcome to you all in my YouTube channel. And today's video is about pharmacy education in Australia. So what are the courses available in Australia for study? And it is also important for you if you are already overseas pharmacist and you are planning to move to Australia, so you can know that what are the courses available and what that the subject they study, you know, and what the structure basically here, you know. So once you are a pharmacist here, and then in the future the pharmacist student will come to you for the internship, or sometimes they come, you know, like sometimes the part-time job, those kind of things, you know. So it is important for you as well. To become a pharmacist in India, if you want to become a pharmacist in India, then you have an option like diploma in pharmacy, bachelor of pharmacy, or PharmD. Any of the degree, if you are complete, you can be a pharmacist in India. The same in Australia, if you want to become a pharmacist, so there is only two options. One is a bachelor of pharmacy, that is program 4 years. And another one is a 2-year master of pharmacy. But here there is additional years needed. So at least pharmacists need to be a 5.5 to 6 year to become pharmacist in Australia. So here in Australia, basically there is a 4-year bachelor program in pharmacy. It's called Bachelor of Pharmacy. This is after 12th or after high school. High school, basically in Australia, they call high school is equivalent to 12th standard in India. So if you are 12th, if you study from those countries, so you can study here. That is a 4-year bachelor of pharmacy. So you have to study 4-year bachelor of pharmacy, then plus you have to go for 1-year internship, and then you have to write 2 exams. One exam for a law, and that law exam is very easy. Basically they just want to know you have the knowledge about the law, and even the books they provide. So in the book, you know, you can see the answer, and you can just, you know, basically there's like a case based scenario. So there's particular case how you react, you know, what the law is here in Australia, you know, so those kind of things. Then another exam is called clinical exam. This is basically OSCE exam. So it's like a case based scenario, and you have to find out the problems in the case, then you have to give your recommendations, those kind of things. This exam is a little bit harder. So even though they are studied here 4-year bachelor of pharmacy in Australia, they also not easy to pass this exam. The next course is here, this is Master of Pharmacy. Master of Pharmacy is Australia. They are given another chance, though they already have a bachelor degree and they are working in pharmacy, or they want to come to the pharmaceutical industry and now they want to study. They already have bachelor degree, but now they think that they want to change their profession. They want to come to pharmacy, and pharmacy is a good profession for them. So they can go for 2-year Master of Pharmacy. So this program also, you know, then after they complete this program, they also have to go for 1 year internship. Then after internship, they have to go same 2 exams they have to write to become a pharmacist in Australia. So in Australia, if you are bachelor degree in honors, you can directly can go for PhD. There is no need for master degree. That's why the most of the students, those are locally Australians, they just did bachelor degree in pharmacy and they just directly enter into the doctor of philosophy in PhD. So there is no need to go for M.Pharm or M.Phil. But there is a, if you did your bachelor of pharmacy in Australia and your score is not that much high, you are not an honors student, then now you have to go for M.Phil, and then you can convert it into a PhD. So M.Phil again is a 2-year program, but in 1/2 year in some universities. So first, after B.Pharm, if your score is low, then you have to go for M.Phil, then you have to complete for a PhD. It is similar like in India, if you are doing any bachelor degree in arts and science, then you have to go M.Phil, then you have to go for a PhD. So now might be some of you are thinking about in Australia, in India, basically like, yeah, in those countries we have Master of Pharmacy in Pharmacology, Pharmaceutical Chemistry, or Pharmaceutics, you know, so those kind of specialization is not available in Australia, and why? That's why I told you that earlier, after bachelor they can directly go for it, PhD, there's no need for masters. But if someone want to go for any specialization, and then they have to go for M.Phil, and M.Phil also available in several branches, pharmaceutics, pharma chemistry, pharmacy practice, whatever you want, you can go. So basically, Australia, whatever they complete bachelor or master, they are local and they got job, you know. So most of the students, they are not going to pursue for higher degrees, for like masters or PhD. But nowadays, you know, because of the saturation, so many of the pharmacists also are going for master degree and PhD. But most of the time, they are working and they are doing as a part time. It's not, they are not doing as a full time. Here, a student mostly they are working as a part time and they are doing part time and job, and they are getting a scholarship for PhD because government is giving a lot of money, and they are just trying to that all the Australians can locals, you know, they can go for higher degree for PhD and research, those kind of. That's why government is giving a lot of scholarship for if local. That's why I said, if you are a bachelor degree from other country and you are planning to move to Australia, then after that you can, once you got PR, then you can go for master degree, you can go for PhD, then no one will ask you, you know. So getting a PR is most important for you.
अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया तो इसे लाइक करें, कमेंट करें और सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें, और बेल आइकन पे जरूर दबाएं ताकि आपको नेक्स्ट वीडियो की नोटिफिकेशन मिलती रहे.